I have been trying my best to get through to Pamilerin. Actually, I made sure I got through to Peruzzi, and you heard what he had to say. But Pamilerin is trying to get here. Traffic is crazy. So I said, you know what? If you cannot get here, I'll make sure I put you on the phone and call you up and have a conversation with you. How are you doing?
I'm very fine.
Welcome to the show, Pamilerin. First of all, I'm not happy. You know I'm not happy.
I'm so sorry, Dr.
No, you know, you shouldn't apologize to everybody.
I'm so sorry, everyone. I could not make it down because traffic. I'm so sorry.
That's okay. How are you? Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much.
Okay, so first, I want to be very honest. I mean, Pamilerin, I want to start with you telling me your own side of the story. Then I can ask you some setting questions, right? But you tell me what exactly transpired, what happened between you and Peruzzi.
Okay. So basically, after Sound City Awards, that's January. And turning one over Peruzzi. Everybody was like, oh, great.
Okay, that's at the headings.
Yes, no, the Sound City actually.
Oh, okay, that's the SMVA.
Yes.
Okay.
So, Peruzzi wasn't cool with it, and he had his opinion. Yeah, it's actually normal for an artist to wear his opinion when he feels like he's entitled to something and it's not going that well.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, so after he had his opinion, you know, people basically came for him and were like, we should not compare his job with Kenny, blah, blah, blah. And basically, he was angry and probably he got into his skinny feelings. So I had my opinion and I was like, Peruzzi never came. What's called? Okay, and with 10 years. That's the point. I did another tweet and I was like, "Who's the Peruzzi for 10 years?" Like a trade. Yeah. I did another one. I wish I think got to him. I said, "Can somebody tell Peruzzi? Can someone tell Peruzzi to shut up?" And that was. I think that was what got him angry and pissed off.
Okay.
So moving on. After 6 months, I was in Bayelsa for a friend's club opening. And I was heading to back to Port Harcourt Airport. Then I think Peruzzi sighted me and asked his sponsor to bring me. So that one just came into the bus and grabbed me. I'd be Pamilerin, I'd be mad. I started saying all sorts of things. I was like, I was lost in thought, like, what was happening? Like, I couldn't share it. Everyone thought it was a joke, so nobody paid attention to it. So he grabbed me and took me to where Peruzzi was. So when I got there, Peruzzi grabbed me and he was trying to have a conversation. But you know about me, I'm only smiling. So basically, he thought I was laughing, then he slapped me.
Okay.
And I was like, what was happening? Nobody saw it coming. It was like that shredded everyone. I was like, what happened? And that was, and he started screaming and he left me.
Okay. How many times did he slap you?
Just once.
Once,
but
okay.
But it was like, I thought it was storm. It was thunderous.
So I had to crack up on that. Sorry about that, but that was really funny. I mean, you try to make a joke out of everything, and but now coming about opinions, and it's a free world. You know, these days, you know, we say things how we feel.
Yeah.
Now, for you, did you see any justification of what you said? And can I ask you this question? Would you say you probably said that because you were a Tenny fan? Are you a Peruzzi fan?
No, I'm not a Tenny fan. I'm not a Peruzzi fan. I'm just a fan of good music.
Oh, you're good music.
I like their songs. I have their songs on my phone.
So you were just being objective as possible.
I was just being objective at that point in time.
Okay. So
I wish I actually took. I took now the tweet and I saw it. That same day, like in less than 1 hour, I took it out.
Okay. So, because I just want to be sure what you said was not emotional. So you're saying it wasn't an emotional tweet. It was how you felt and it was your opinion, right?
It was just an opinion. I had nothing against it.
Okay, good. Now, based on your track record of things you say on Twitter, right? Somebody asked me to say this to you, that you constantly attack setting people. I mean, you're known for opening up your mind and saying things how it is. Do you ever see yourself getting into trouble doing that, you know, oftentimes?
Because the thing is, people come for me every time on Twitter, and I've never for once assaulted anyone. Even when we meet the person, you're like, guy, you offend me, and that's it. They come for me every time on Twitter. If it's not Ninja Turtles today, it's another thing tomorrow.
True.
So I don't get my feelings with all those things.
Okay. So did you ever at any point, did you work for Peruzzi? Did you do any job for him?
I'm actually that same day when I took out the tweet, I actually asked to promote him on my channel, and people were like, "Ah, Pamilerin, just as he started this guy, so like, so this is a paid advert." You guys, actually asked to promote it immediately.
Okay. Okay, so now on the basis of the conversation that started already, because you know I called him up and he had a, you know, people have talked about asshole now, whether you like it or not, that's what he is. There's no way to waste these things. So, what is your next step? Are you going to sue him? Are you dropping any? Are you going to press charges, or are you just going to sort it out as friends and just let it go?
The thing is. So I did not put out any content because my team asked me not to put out any content.
Yeah.
I did not say anything about the old Snap thing. I did not see anything I don't post on Instagram. So I'm just with my team. I'm a 6-2 person. You should know me though. So I don't like Wala.
Yeah.
So anything my team decides, I'm ready for it. Anything. I'm not.
Okay, so you're letting your team handle this.
Yeah, I'm
so this might go either ways. It might be a case if your team decides you sue him, right?
Yeah, I don't have a choice. Anything I should do, I do. But I don't think it should get to that point.
Okay. But just asking you, as forgetting what a team is, if you had your way, what exactly would you do? Be honest.
Right now?
Yeah. If you had your way, what exactly would you do? Let's forget the team. If you had your way, what exactly are you going to do? Are you going to sue him? Or are you going to let it go?
That's just to have a conversation. I need to let him understand that it's actually never that serious. Okay. Because you have to get your feelings like that every time, then you should be ready to beat up everybody on Twitter. Trust me. What will Davido do? They come for this guy every day. What should they risk do? They come for this guy every day. What should Copy do? They come for these people every day.
Can I ask you, but do you think sometimes, you know, based on what you're saying, you come for people, do you realize sometimes even the things we say can actually affect somebody's state of mind? You know, sometimes you say things to people and it commits suicide. Sometimes you say things to people, they get depressed. Are you saying that, you know, based on his occupation or whatever it is, or whatever he stands for as a public figure, it should not take it to heart? He should just take it and whether or not it affects him or it doesn't. I mean, what's your take on that?
Doctor, the thing is, I've been in this situation before and I know what it takes to be there.
Yeah.
People come for me every time, even more than they come for Peru. So I tend to understand is this is just an app.
Yeah.
Once these things come, I close the app up. I go find something else. I rather sleep or go swimming. So the moment we realize that people will always talk, yes, that sometimes it gets into it will get to you, but you have to realize that probably it's better to even use it and just using borrowed data to tweet nonsense.
Yeah.
So you have to understand this and just let it go. Nothing will change it. This is Nigeria. People will keep doing this. People will keep coming for you. There's no way you can stop it.
Okay.
It's not like that. It's not going to end anytime soon.
Okay. So, can I ask you a question off the record? Off the record. I mean, what do you think about feminism?
What I think about Peruzzi?
No, what do you think about feminism? What's your take on it?
I can be a feminist, but the way Nigerians talk about feminism, it's not it. Especially if you talk it through, I think it's something else entirely. Change it into something else, that's not feminism. We don't practice that in Nigeria. So I'm a fan of 50-50, and that's just me.
Okay, so I mean, what this is you know, you told us what happened in Bayelsa, right? And because you didn't attend the first party, so did you avoid the first day because you know it was going to be performing there?
Actually, I left off, and I was not just in the mood to attend the party. Maybe because of what would have happened, I had no idea. I was not just in the mood to go to the party.
Okay. So you didn't see this coming.
I never saw it coming.
Okay. So anyway, thank you so much, Pamilerin, for your time. And hopefully we're going to hear from your team and what they decide. I just heard Davido apologize to you. And I think he has apologized to you as well, right? He did on the radio. I'm not sure he sent you any personal. Did he send you any personal message? Did he call you? Did he?
I'll have to check now.
Okay, fine then. But you're saying we're leaving the decision to your team, right?
Yes.
So whatever your team says, we'll go with it.
Yes,
so it can be a court case and it can be, you know, actual forgiveness, right?
Yes.
Thank you so much, Pamilerin.
Thank you so much
for your time, and keep working out, bro. Have a nice day.